one, the lifeblood of capitalism. As a matter of fact, it accounts for about 70% of all income coming into the Canadian government. However, it has its downfalls, from encouraging prejudice and racism to the objectification of human beings. Consumerism has various negative effects. On the contrary, consumerism creates employment opportunities and benefits the overall national and international economy. To make sales, corporations increase the amount of marketing. These higher levels of marketing lead to sales and many other effects that we will go through in this documentary. First of all, there are many positive outcomes of consumerism. When people buy items from the store, they're supporting the wage of the store employee as well as that of the factory worker. Consumerism gives us the choice to make our own decisions when it comes to purchasing. It allows us to decide which products stay on the market and which ones do not. Consumerism provides citizens with choices of what they want. Through consumerism, people can start their own businesses and thrive through them. The rise in consumerism has resulted in more industrial production, so that means more availability of goods and services in our society. It also helps in increasing the employment opportunities for everyone. Through consumerism, people and countries become wealthy. Countries can tax goods, giving them wealth. With this wealth, they can provide services such as healthcare without having to drastically increase taxes. People can start their own business, as there will always be a market for the product, and consumerism creates wealth and prosperity for all. But what is prosperity? By definition, prosperity is the state of being affluent in material and financial terms. Consumerism is great at making countries and select individuals prosperous. But what about the average people who don't have the opportunity to be wealthy? Average people who aren't in the select few are only affected by the negatives of consumerism and marketing. The largest negative effect of consumerism and marketing is the effect on the human brain. When human brains repeatedly see something, then they subconsciously believe it to be true. This is how marketers get consumers to purchase their products. When consumers view these advertisements, such as those created on Photoshop, they constantly will want to become exactly like the Photoshop version of reality. This is the main cause of eating disorders such as anorexia, but eating disorders are not the only consequence of media and marketing. Another consequence is that of the environment. With an extremely large market for production, the usage of non-renewable resources has dramatically increased. It creates a demand for resources that is unsustainable in the long term. The Greek philosopher Plato once said, "The greatest wealth is to live content with little." According to Plato, living with happiness but minimal possessions is the greatest way to live. Consumerism creates an immense demand for people to keep on buying things, leading them to be constantly dissatisfied with what they have. We feel better when we can purchase more stuff, but become insecure when we can't afford something. So in the end, we all become more insecure and devalued if we cannot buy as much as others. It creates a society where we constantly want more and we will never be satisfied. After we meet our basic needs of qualities of life levels when compared to the standard of living. On top of all of this, people's lives are individually affected. Through consumerism, people work extremely long hours, not spending enough time with their children or family members. This really puts a damper on family life and people's happiness. The average numbers of hours worked in Norway, a country less focused on consumerism, is 1,447 hours. In the United States, it's 1,789 hours per year. Nearly 400 hours of more time spent with your family and focus on the more important things in life. The current rate at which we are consuming is currently off the charts. If everyone in the world consumed products like the average American did, we would need about 5 planets to sustain the lost resources and factories. And this number is going up. Countries specifically in the East are moving towards the Western ideology of consumerism. The current number of people who live as consumers around the world are 2 billion. By 2030, however, this number will double to be around 4 billion. At this rate, there will be no more world for us to live on. To make matters worse, the increased number of factories leads to an accelerated speed of global warming. So, as you can see by the facts laid forth in this documentary, consumerism has its ups and downs. Many believe that consumerism contains too many negatives and should be replaced. But how can you change the status quo?